Welcome to another tutorial. This time I will show you Java, how to build, how to create a Hangman. Hangman game with Java, using Java. We will use the swing library. First of all, I want to show you that inside my users folder, okay, my name, documents, NetBeans projects, Hangman, this is in Greek. Greek is Kremala. In English is Hangman. If you go to source folder, you'll see here all the Greek letters of the Greek alphabet. Okay. Okay. Let me show you the code. This is the code. Don't be afraid of the length of the quantity of the code. It's very easy. All you have to do is copy paste some commands inside your project. I will show you immediately. First of all, our main class is this one, Hangman Kremala, that extends JFrame. So we can use the action listener command class and create the JPanel to add components inside the JPanel. These are very, very important imports. If you want to build a swing application in Java, you have first of all to include these imports: javax.swing.asterisk, java.dot.dot.asterisk, java.dot.dot.event.asterisk, and javax.swing.event.asterisk. All the other imports are mainly for the MySQL connection. So what do we do here? I have a JPanel, the main window. I have, of course, 24 buttons, J buttons, for the Greek letters. I have a Greek layout that I don't use it, so let me comment it. I don't use the Greek layout, because if you use the Greek, all the components that you add after you have added the grid layout inside your panel will expand as long as they need to expand. So for example, a J button will be like this inside your panel, and we want J buttons to be small, and the J buttons, if you use a grid, will be very big, because they tend to get to use all the room you give inside your grid, okay? Of course, I give to the user 8 lives, 8 tries to find a word, and this is a J level that says you have this number of lives, another J levels, another J label, that it says that you have given and some letters. These are the letters, this text area. It accepts 8 letters. It's not really very important, because inside the text area you can write as many letters as you want. And a font. I use a font. Verdana is random font, bold, 25. After that, I have another J label. It says the word you need to find is this. And this is the word we have to find. And I'll explain what these two strings are here for. So inside my constructor, I have some exceptions I catch here. Okay, you can see it. And then I start to add the components one per one inside my object. Oh, my object is my J panel. First I add the J label. After that I add the text area. After that I add the other J label. I set the font. This font here. This font. With the set font function. And I say that the color of the letters would be red. And I say that you cannot write inside this text area. I do the same thing for the word. And after that, I have built in MySQL, I'll show you, I have built this database named Cremala. I have for the time present, one table, animals, zoo means animals, with two columns, one column ID and the other word, the word. Lex, it means the word. And you can see here the animals I have inserted inside my database. Number one is elephant. Number two is rhinoceros. Number three is lion. Number four is, I don't know how to say this, rabbit. Rabbit, duck, etc. Chicken, a dog. So after that, I try to connect with my database. I use this string here, URL. Here, if you run this application into a server, you can write the IP of the server, of course. And after that, the port. I explain very analytically. Έλα, Βαγγέλη. Γυρίζω βίντεο για το YouTube. Θα σε πάρω εγώ σε μισή ώρα. Έλα, γεια. I'm explaining very... I'm explaining very carefully, very analytically, to understand. I don't know your knowledge, your background for the MySQL connection, so I will try to be more precise and give you directions how to connect correctly with MySQL. So you have the old way is this, and more secure way. New instance, class for name, you can find it. Okay. So after that, you have to create a connection with MySQL, and use driver manager, get connection. This driver manager you have imported here, driver manager, SQL driver manager. You have SQL exception, statement for the query. You have to ask for to MySQL. And this is enough for the MySQL. So driver manager, get connection with this string here, JDBC. Of course, in order to have MySQL connection, you have to go to libraries, Azure folder, and you select this MySQL connector. You can now download it from the internet, from the Google. You have to write free download MySQL connector Java, and you can download from the site of MySQL. Okay. Then I have to search for an ID. I have to find an ID here, this ID here, and to select the word that is a reference to this ID. So what I do, I create an object, a class, random, new random class, and I say that I have to find a number between 1 and 10. With next int. And after that, I create a statement with the object connection. I create a statement. So I can ask MySQL this query here. It says select the word from animals where ID is equals to this number. So every time I run the application, the program, it chooses another word. After that, I have a result set that returns the results of this query here, of this statement, and I execute the query, this query here. And of course, this returns only one word, one string. And I assign this string here with this column. Column 0 is the ID, column 1 is the word. To this string here, AA. And this is for me to know what word the program has chosen in order to make the application. After that, what I do? This is a string, okay? So I assign a underscore and a blank space. I don't give any length to the string. And if, for example, the program has chosen number 9 chicken, quota, this will have 8 letters. It will have 4 underscores and 4 blank spaces. Okay. After that, I append the word. I append this thing here to the text field, the text area, and I add to my JPanel. After that, it's very easy because I have all the letters inside my source file, my source folder. For each position of the array J buttons, alpha, I say that this icon will be inside the J button. And in order to get for the folder of the source file, this image here, I say get class dot get resource, because we want to get the class, the running class, this class here that we have created. The get resource, we want from the main class to get the resource we need, and this resource for this example is this image here, and this I do for every button. For every button, for 24 buttons. Okay. So what I do next? For every button, I create an action listener event. And of course you probably know that when you create an action listener event, you have to write this function here, public void action perform, and this is for the click event, and you have to say an action event, and if you get the source, the get source means that you have clicked this button here, the first button, the alpha letter. What I do here? I use two char arrays. I copy the string, the word we have from the MySQL query, inside the first char array, and the underscores with the blank spaces to the second char array. So then I can make a search. I can make a search inside this char array here. And if I find the letter A, because I know that when the user clicks this letter here, I have to search for the letter A. Okay, I know because it's the first button of the word, of the letters. And I say that because this help string has twice the characters of this string here, I say that 2 multiplied I will be A. So I assign, let's say that your word is this, and the help is this. So I say that the fourth, this is 0, 1, 2, 3. So I say that if the third letter will be A, the sixth letter of the GG char array will be A. So 0, 1, 2, 3. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This would be A. Okay. Okay. And I say that J is 1. So we have found a letter. Because if we haven't found a letter, lives must be reduced by 1. And I show a message to the user that says, you found the letter A. After that, I convert the array GG to the string help, to a string, and I say that the word, the text area string, will the text of the text area word will be the help. And of course, if we haven't found a letter, lives will be reduced. And it says here, the letter A doesn't exist. And the letters that the user has, that the user has entered, and they are not exist inside the word that the user must find, I set the text to the letters get text that of the existing text of the text area letters plus this letter here, the A. And after that, I set visible this button here. I say that I remove it from the J panel. You can use set at double false. So the button will remain inside your J panel, but it won't. But the user will not be able to click again. But I prefer to remove it for my personal likeness. Okay. And then I say that. I set the text of this J label here to you have plus lives, and then I have to check if the lives are zero. If the lives are zero, that means that the user has lost. So I say you lose, play again, try again. And then I say all the buttons will be not no, this I don't know why I have done twice. Let me remove it. Control S, I save it. And then what I do? In order to find that if the user has found the word, I use two other char arrays, JJ and UU. Be careful. The char array UU must have the length of the string of the word that MySQL has returned. Okay, otherwise this if here will not work. Okay, be careful of that. So I say that a JJ will be the underscores array, the underscore string plus the blank spaces. And I convert it to a char array. Okay. After that, I say that if we have found another scorer blank space, we increase the counter I. First I 0. I counts the positions of this array here. And J counts the position of this array here. Else if letter is not underscore, we have found a letter. We say that inside this char array we'll store the letter of this array here. And we increase also the two counters. And after that, we convert this char array UU to this string KK. And then we are able to check if the KK equals that this KK is the letters, the word that the user has entered so far. Okay, so if it's equals to the string, to the word that MySQL has returned, we say you won, play, try again. And we say else, you say that you have to find all the letters. Okay, and this I do for exactly the same code for all the letters. For the letters, this is B, Vita. For all the letters, I do the same thing. Okay. For 24 buttons. Let me remove this. What happened? Okay. And after that, I add the J label that shows how many lives the user has so far, and of course you have to include this piece of line here, send code and paint, the jpanel object, the jpanel you have declared, and in order to be able to see all the components. And this here is very important, this function here, paint, it takes an object, graphics, G, in order to paint the Hangman inside your application. Here I set the color of the lines and the shapes. I set the rendering hint and I set the stroke. I prefer the 8 width of stroke. And I say if life is 8, draw two lines. Then draw the head. If life is 7, draw the head. Draw the right hand, draw the left hand, draw the right foot. Draw the left foot, draw the mouth, draw the body, draw the mouth, and after that draw two lines. And this is my main. Okay, let me run it to see exactly what I mean. You see here has chosen the word elephant. You see here all the Greek letters. And this is the help text area. This is the letters that the user has entered and are false. Let me say this omega. It says the letter omega doesn't exist. You have to find all the letters. And in order to see the head, you have to resize. Let me say theta. You see the body. Let me say eta. You see the right hand. Let me give gamma. Let me give zeta. Let me give psi. You see here, you have two lives. Let me give psi. This is the mouth. Let me see, let me give M. It says here, you lose. Play again. And you see here this. If I run it again, let me this time find the word. It says here you won, play again. So, with this piece of code, you can play Hangman. Of course, you can do several other things, little things. You can choose the table, the category you want to play. Let's say plants, let's say professions. Let's say cities and countries, and you can create a main class with a select, and you select a category, and then send to another class the selected index, the number, so you can with a if statement. Find the suitable table and ask and connect to this table in order to find a word to play with. And of course you can use another class and when the game finishes to play again with a J option message, input message and ask for the user if he wants to play again. So, in this way, you can play as many times as you want. And you can write as many words as you like inside the MySQL database. Okay, thank you very much. Goodbye.